Hello, everyone. This is Tucker Christensen with Advertising Cloud Product Management here at Adobe. And today we're going to be talking about the new Analytics for Advertising Cloud integration. This is the new integration that brings view-through tracking from AdCloud into Analytics. So our display advertisers have a challenge in the industry, and that is that oftentimes people are seeing ads, but they're not clicking on those ads. This makes it very difficult to understand how those ads are performing, to measure them, to optimize them, and so on. With the new integration, however, when someone sees an ad and they don't click on it and they land on the site, AdCloud is able to tell Analytics what that last ad impression was, and we can capture that in Analytics as a view through. And then from there, once we have that captured, we're able to see how that view through impacts downstream metrics, just like a click-through would. So with this integration, we now have the silver bullet to be able to get the display advertisers the data they need to be able to do this sort of optimization. So this is a native bi-directional integration between Analytics and Advertising Cloud. It starts with dimensions and metrics coming out of Advertising Cloud over to Analytics that we can use in analysis and reporting. And then Analytics also pushes metrics back over to AdCloud that can be used for our algorithms as we do automated bidding. We can also take segments out of Analytics into Advertising Cloud to use those for rich segments for our targeting efforts. So today we're going to take a look at some of the basics here using this data inside of Analysis Workspace and what sort of metrics and dimensions we get with this. Here's a quick list of all the dimensions and metrics. On the left hand here, we have the new integration with the DSP. And on the right hand, we have the previously existing integration that our search customers use. You'll notice a lot of these are the same dimensions, like ad platform account and so on. So we'll actually bring all this data together into the same dimensions in Analytics so you can see your display and your search data side by side. Now let's take a look at this data inside of Analysis Workspace. To start off with, filter on the left-hand side for AMO, and this will get you all of your dimensions and metrics that come in with this integration. And then from there, it's simply dragging and drop to pull up your reports. For example, I've built out the ad platform report here. This is the highest level of the ad hierarchy. So for our DSP, you'll see Advertising Cloud DSP, and all the data is under that. If you have search as well, you would see Google AdWords, Microsoft Bing, and so on. It's a high-level search engine. Deeper levels of this would be the advertiser, then the campaign, then the ads and placements, and so on. From a metrics perspective, we bring in that new view-throughs metric. This is captured on the website when the view-through occurs, so it is fully connected to the visitor profile. So not only can I pull it into these new dimensions, like ad platform, but I can pull it into other dimensions as well, such as entry pages, to see where people are landing on my site with a view-through. We also bring in click cost and impression at summary level. These ones, you'll note, they have the little triangle icon on them with a little pop-up here on this. Since these are summary level, they can only be used with AMYD dimensions. So those are the dimensions with the little parentheses over here. And you can use them with those reports. And our dimensions are also fully connected to orders, visits, revenue, page views, so on, like all the other metrics that are happening on the website. And of course, you can use these in the various visualizations as well. Let's say I'm doing some analysis here, and I wanted to look at my AdCloud campaigns. The first thing I've done here is I've created a segment for my AdCloud DSP hits. This is a hit level segment where the AMOID starts with AC exclamation point. So the AMOID is where we put all of the AdCloud tracking codes, and then all of the DSP tracking codes start with AC exclamation point, whereas search would start with AL exclamation point. So this filters it down. So I'm looking at just my campaigns coming from the DSP. And then I can drill into this further. Let's say I wanted to see how the ads were performing on this first campaign. Just drag and drop in there. I can see the various ads and their performance. If I want to drill into this a little bit further, let's take placement, drag and drop down on that first ad there, and now I can see how the placements are doing. So the placement is your targeting strategy. So that's, think of this as the types of sites that you want your advertisements to show up on, or the audiences that you want to see those. So with this, I'm able to do these breakdowns here quick and easy. I'm able to get all that key data that I need with this, but I can go beyond just looking at basic click cost impression data plus conversions, as I'm able to see all of my Analytics data in here. So it's really powerful. Of course, I can bring dimensions in here directly without doing the breakdowns. For example, I've got the ad type dimension here. This is another big one. I can see the various types of ads that I'm running out of the DSP. So for example, I've got standard display, interactive pre-roll, that's a video type of ad, native display ads, and so on. So we can bring in with this integration any of our ads that are served up in web-based environments. So that could be mobile web or desktop web. So that's it for a high-level overview. If you're interested in getting this integration set up, reach out to your Ad Cloud account manager and they can get you started with the implementation on this. And we'll be looking at doing some future videos to talk about more advanced examples of analysis, such as advanced landing page optimization with this, as well as how this can be incorporated into marketing channels. Thank you.